So in this vlog, let's try to continue with the concept of Flutter hooks. And now we are going to see the implementation of a Flutter hook, which is the easiest of all the available Flutter hooks here, which is nothing but use context. We will be trying to see the implementation of the use context hook Flutter application in this part of this tutorial. And also I would like to share you that this is the easiest hook, which is also easy to understand. It might be quite confusing for you, like how to use this particular hook, but the usage is very simple and very clear to understand. So this part of the tutorial, I will be clearing you the doubts of how to use this particular hook in your programming. So let's get started. Before going, let us try to know something about the context here in our Flutter application. So what is a context? So everything in a Flutter is a widget. So this point is we are all aware of. Even for a beginner, you might be aware like everything in a Flutter is made up of widgets. So what are all the things you will be seeing on the screen is nothing but a widget. So it's like a text widget, button widget, an image. All these things are made up of widgets here on our Flutter application. So these widgets need to be properly handled. For example, you are having multiple text widgets on your screen. How you can display some data on a particular text widget, or how you can handle the button click of a particular widget, or else how you can handle a particular button click of all the available buttons. For example, you are having 10 buttons on your screen. Then how you can handle a particular 5th button click or a 6th button click. So how you can make use of all this? So with the help of a context, you can handle all these particular scenarios. So what context does? Let's try to see. All these widgets are available in a hierarchy, like that is one over the other. This forms a widget tree over there. So within the widget tree, you need to handle all the widgets. Like I have said in our previous point, where out of all the widgets, how you can handle a particular widget, right? So inside the widget tree, if you want to handle a particular widget, then you need to make use of this particular context here. So context is nothing but a handle to the location of the widget. So let's try to imagine there are 10 widgets on your screen and you want to handle especially a particular 5th widget, which is nothing but a button. So you want to tap on the particular button and make a certain functionality to happen in your application. So within the widget tree, so you need to know the exact location of that particular button, which is nothing but here context. So you are trying to get the context of that particular widget here. I hope you are clear by now. So context is a build context instance. We will be seeing an example there. You will be knowing what is a build context and for which how you will get the context there. So I will be showing you a practical example. So context is an instance. So we are creating an instance for the build context and we are making use of it. You may call any method like method of context. So this particular 5th point I have shown you as an example in this tutorial. So let's go ahead and try to see the particular example so that you will get a very good clarity. And by the end of this tutorial, you will be adding this particular use context hook immediately to your application because it's that easy and very simple to use and also very useful. So now let's try to see an example over it. So now let us try to see the example of how to use context in our Flutter application. So quickly, let's try to build up the skeleton of our application. So let's start with void main and specify the run app. So if you are very much familiar with these implementations, you can just skip and directly go through the usage of use context. So for the beginners, you may just follow this tutorial so that you will get an idea of how to implement use context right from basics. So let's try to create a stateless widget for now. So this will be named like my app. So now instead of container, let's try to return a material app. So inside the material app, we need to consider home and there specify scaffold. So exactly this is a scaffold which will provide us the structure like for our application, like app bar, body, all these things. and also like floating action button. There are a lot of things you can just consider inside the scaffold. So for now, let's try to consider app bar and body. Inside the app bar, let's specify the title with the help of a text widget over here. So now let's try to specify hooks as a title. So within the body, let us try to specify one more class called home. And now let's try to create this particular class. Let us try to create one more stateless widget. And now let us try to turn this stateless widget into a hook widget so that we can make use of hook concept in our application. So instead of returning a container, let us try to return a text widget itself directly. So within the text widget, let us try to specify hello world. So let us try to specify hello world inside the text widget. So now let's try to run this code and try to observe the output, and later we will try to make use of use context in this particular example. And now our application is been successfully shown up on our iOS simulator here. And also make sure you import Flutter hooks here, because we are making use of hook widget here. So we have extended our home class with hook widget instead of a stateless widget. So now let's try to make use of the use context now. So how we can make use of the use context here? So within the text widget, let us try to specify style here, so that inside the style we would like to make use of context, right? So default text style dot of, and here we require context. So just to explain you the usage of use context here, I am making use of this particular example. So here you need to make use of context here. So here we are getting context, so we are trying to pass context here. So dot style dot apply. So I would like to use font factor here. So font size factor, and let us specify 5.0 so that it could be visible. So now let us try to run this code, and here you can see our hello world is now, the font size is now increased. So yes, this is the best example we can say just to make use of context in our code here. So you can just make it to the center. To make use of context here, we are getting context, but what if we have a separate method? So here we are having the text widget within the build, so we are able to make use of the context here directly. So what if it is away, like away from the build method here? So how we can make use of this particular thing? So let's try to create a function display, and inside which let us try to return, and now let's try to cut this and paste it over here so that we are able to return a text widget. So now let's make use of the display here instead, and now try to run this code. So here you can see we have got an error like undefined name context here, so we are not able to fetch the context which is in the build method. What the thing you need to do is like you need to pass the context over here and you need to accept it. And now let's try to save the code, and here you can see we have got hello world now again displayed. So we can see hello world is displayed again. So if you want to make some changes to observe the change, you can just make it hello world 1, and yes, it's printed now. We want to make use of the use context hook here. We don't want to pass it as a parameter here, but we want to make use of this particular function to display some text onto the screen. So you can clearly make use of use context here directly. So now where we need to make use of use context? Should we declare it over here somewhere like final context equal to use context, and we need to make use of this particular thing here? So will this work? Let's try to run and see the code, and still we are getting an error here, and also we can't use it like this. So here we are getting method invocation is not a constant expression. So no, we cannot use it like this, like we did in our previous examples for memoization, use state, all these things. So how we can make use of this? How we can make use of the use context here? Instead of context here, you can just directly replace it with use context and try to increment the number to 2 here so that we can observe the change clearly. And now just try to save the code here, and here you can see hello world 2 is being displayed here. So we have not passed any context here to the display method, or we are not getting the context here. With the help of this use context hook, we have declared the hook widget, right? So we can make use of the context of this particular class here inside the display function. So you can just directly make use of the particular context of the hook widget. In this way, you can make use of this particular use context hook in your application, and this is very easy and simple to use Flutter hook. So I hope you use this in your program and avoid passing of context as an additional parameter to your function. So yes, I hope you are very much confident about the particular example which you have seen, and I think you like this tutorial as well. So do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.